Today I'll talk about the challenges in making the nano-imprint master template, especially in template patterning kind of things. So outline is just recent progress in the nano-imprint for CMOS, and challenges in imprint template, master template, so kind of things, and focusing on the patterning challenges, and finally I will summarize that. So as you know, the template strategy is to make a very expensive EB master and to make a replica to use in the fab kind of things. So we have to use electron beam system to make a master and also the replication system to make a replica template in our site. And basically the master template process is exactly the same as like a 4X reticle kind of things. Use the e-beam writing system to on the resist and develop and etch the quartz, and we inspect that, and if we find a defect, we will repair that. So that's always the same challenges in the mask making. And in addition, in the replication, we have a new challenge in imprinting process. So like a defect control also, and image placement control between the master and the replica, also including the CD uniformity kind of things. And finally, we have to etch the quartz again to make a replica template. So there is a kind of a comparison between the nominal 4X reticle and the 1X master. So most of the difference is the magnification. So template is 1X size compared with optical or even EUV mask is 4X size. And field size is currently nano-imprint needs 26 by 33. It's exactly the same as the optical scanner's field. And the substrate is the same. It's a 6-inch quartz. And the thickness is about 6 millimeter kind of things. And we will use mask fabrication, as I said. For master is electron beam, the replica is imprint technologies. And especially for the, we need a resolution kind of things. So the imprint template process, we use a very high resolution, low sensitivity, mostly a non-chemically amplified resist. So that's a little bit difference. So there is a kind of challenges in template for the resolution and also the defective control, because the imprint lithography is actually close to the contact print kind of things. So the particle and the defect control is very important. And some kind of the degradation will happen from the master to replica when we replicate the image. So I will just review the general performance status. Mostly the data from collected from half pitch 3X nanometer generation. So this is a replica template CD uniformity across the 33 by 26 field. So CD uniformity is already 1.5 nanometer kind of things. Because of the field size is compared with the 4X, it's small. So it's easier, relatively easier to get a good CD uniformity. That's good. And also, as I said, some kind of degradation will happen in the image placement from the master template to the replica template. So this is a kind of example. So we measure the like a 1.2 nanometer residual image placement error in the master template. After we imprint for the replica template, we got about a 2.5 nanometer image placement error. So you can see that especially the corner part, you can get additional error in the corner because of the distortion when we release the plate. But the 2.5 is so good. And mostly important issue is defectivity control. So this is the kind of history of our replica template defect density. So we start to replication process development in 2011. At that time, we got millions of defects per square centimeters.
But we gradually, you know, improved our process to eliminate a non-fill defect or plug defect or reduce the muscle damage. And finally, we tuned the process to reduce the defect in the process. So 2 years ago, we got less than one defect per square centimeters defect density and a replica template. And also that we evaluate the stability of the defect control. So this is a kind of the 16 replica template defect analysis. So the, every template has less than 5 pieces per square centimeters defect density. So it's will it's meet at our first preliminary goal. So this is a kind of a summary of like a half pitch 3x level target. So our first target is a defectivity 1 defect per square centimeters. So as a champion data, but we got 0.6 in 2 years ago. And the CD deformity is less than 2. And the image placement is, as I said, just a target of 2.5. So we think the template quality is very useful for the, that kind of the node. And this morning session, there is an update of status of a half pitch 2x and also the 1x generation template defect in the presentation from Toshiba. So as you can see that the 2x nanometer half pitch, so it started to the 2010. Still, it's 1,000 of defects per square centimeter there, but we get less than 0.1 last year for 2x. And for the 1x, we'll start at about 3 years ago, 2 years ago. And still, today, we have more than 100 defects per square centimeter for 1x because of the very small features. But we are going to reduce that kind of things as in the past. So our target and the expected goal is less than 0.1 in the next year and less than 0.01 2 years from now. Okay, so the main topics is the patterning challenges. As I said, so at especially for the 1x target for the next generation, the resolution is a kind of the key. So this is our current performance of resolution with our current process. On the master template, we can have close to the half pitch 17 nanometer on the template. But when we replicate on the replication process, that the pattern will degrade a little bit. So that, on the replica template, we can say that the half pitch 18 nanometer is a kind of the process limit with the current process. But very recently, we evaluated multi-beam mask writer with a 10 nanometer beam size. And we confirmed that 15 nanometer line spaces are resolved with a very good line with roughness kind of things compared with current electron beam system with systems. So both systems use the same non-chemically amplified resist. And even you know, compared with a 100 keV e-beam system, which has a very good resolution, maybe down to the 14 nanometer kind of things. But as you know, that the system is throughput is quite slow. But also the multi-beam mask writer system has a throughput advantage compared with this 100 keV system with equivalent you know, resolution. So this is a kind of comparison table. So for 1D line space features, current BSB writers will take a larger than 1 day kind of the writing time, and the resolution is close to 20 nanometer. And we are working on a next generation BSB system. So it will improve the resolution down to the 17 nanometer. But still the writing time is little over one day. And we will complete this process this year. And finally, our target is to use the multi-beam writer. As I mentioned, that the resolution is down to 15 nanometer, and writing time itself is less than 5 hours. So that's a kind of a combination of a resolution and the throughput solution, and we will get this solution next year. And also, we think that the further challenges in the front of us, because of we are going to apply the imprint technology for 2D features, or even a hole or a pillar kind of arrays, and even angled lines kind of things. So in that case, the current VSB system may need more additional writing time. And we think that the multi-beam writer's concept is do not add the throughput because of the pattern features kind of things. So the multi-beam mask writer's writing times depend on the writing area, not the pattern features category kind of things. Okay, so the summary. So currently we are working on NIL template progress, template in a CMOS application, and I show you the progress in the CD uniformity and the image placement and the defectivity kind of things. Of course, we have we need to working on future improvement on a half pitch 1x nanometer, and there is a patterning challenges of the master template with e-beam, so resolution, and also the throughput. So as I said in the previous page, I believe that the multi-beam mask writer is a kind of solution in the very near future. So thank you very much.